Hello everyone, Xenosim here, and welcome back to Let's Play Blaster Master 03. It's time for the final battle. First, Sophia G1, Jason to defy Kane. Warning, Sophia the Third, Nora MA1, the metal attacker. Before we do anything, Kane Gardner. Huh. To be honest, I'm not sure I can beat him. You're right, Fred. My goal isn't to beat Kane. I have only one reason to fight, to protect our cradle of hope. To the very end, I'll have to use our rush prototype in G Sophia SV's stead. I'm counting on you, Sophia J1. Sophia J1 is just like its old prototype. Everything's here. It might as well just be Sophia. Unleashing our first Excel Blast. Sophia Force Shot will do a bit of damage because it's strong against Sophia Force Machines. Unleash another Excel Blast. Go aggressive. Take too much damage. Eve comes up to help us. Got full health. Unleash full Excel Blast. That's how easy Jason's version. Now, for Jason to defy Kane, to Kane to stop Jason in the Metal Attacker. First time fighting Jason. Earth MA J1, Sophia J1. We're taking a beating already. Ugh. Don't be surprised if I have to reset. Like I said, this is my first time trying with this. So I know that this will take a bit. So I have to learn the pattern. Let's go. Nope, that didn't work. This is going to be difficult. I mean, I could cheese it and try something to cheese it. That ain't fun. Fearful shot is dangerous. We got close. We're getting closer. He's just not using the warhead missiles, which is messing me up because I would be using the home missiles so much more. I'm just gonna trash that run. I need to make sure I don't get hit early on. Thank you.
Nope.
You need to use a warhead missiles more. So I can actually get through. But we're so close. I thought we were using a different wave of attacks at that point. But no. Keep that attack power. Oh no, this attack power. That attack pattern came at the worst time. I wish we didn't need to wait. I wish we could just choose. Keep forgetting how fast how it comes out. If you didn't have the Sphere Force shot, I don't think this would be as bad. It's all because of the anti-Sphere Force shot, which honestly does make this fight more interesting compared to the usual. Yeah, I'm leaving all these outtakes in because, like, you guys gotta see how brutal this is. Especially for someone, again, this is my first time fighting this. So, was that a smart idea? No. Oh. Nope. Anti-Sophia shot. Ugh. Oh! Oh. Actually... okay, so could probably use this to head backwards and collect one of my upgrades. Up there. Yep. Normally we'd not be doing this, but it's clear I really need it because I cannot use Gain. Oh, we can just head down here. Thank you. really... Now we can get. Finally. There we go. Hopefully, that'll be enough. Now I've got to find my way back to my tank. Really? You're really going to do this to me now? Here, once again. Slowly climb down. Oh my god. Stop. Game. stop. Okay, just drop down. Hopefully, that should be enough for now. Hopefully. And there we go, your face, finally. Why? I don't know why you didn't take that you have taken. Honestly, scrap that run. That should have taken. I did switch. Game. Now, not getting in immediately, I sort of get. No, I don't know why Jason didn't go in. But that worked. Nope. I missed it. Oh. It's not fully charged. And just got to hope. Elise! We beat it. Gah! Kane! A strong Jason. My metal attacker is still going strong. I'm not done yet. I'll protect our Creel of Hope. I'll protect him to the end. Am I too late? Not all. In fact, you're right on time. Eve! Jason, thank you for protecting us. Sorry it took so long. No problem, Eve. Protecting you is my reason for living. Alright, let's meet them. Come here, Elfie, Roddy. Are those children? Twins? What's going on here? You two. These two are our children. Human children. You and Eve had... Are you serious? These are our children. Our purely human children. This cocoon served as a vessel so we could give birth to human children. This was our way of making sure Eve could leave behind a physical remnant. That giant cocoon was created solely to give birth to your children. Eve would pass down her mutant queen and superdimensional life form traits to the children, so we needed time to remove those factors in order to ensure the children would be born safely as humans. So to buy time, we needed some help to slow you down, Kane. Gombe, Kana, Stein, and Leibniz. Even the support droids helped ourselves. Tay, Kenwood, Tessa. I see. So that's what they're role was. But why was all this necessary? Eve's evolution is progressing. She's already surpassed physically. Physical form. And become a pure being. A being of pure thought. Soon, she'll assimilate with superdimensional space herself. We're already incapable of living in normal space with everyone. Yet we still wanted to leave proof of our existence, no matter what. Was that the dream you had to fulfill? If you say what we did was wrong, I won't correct you on that. This is a burden we will always have to bear. How exactly do you plan on raising these children? If you truly are human, then you already know we can't live here. That's right, as humans, if we can't live long in some dimensional space, we can't be together with them for very long. Now that I don't have a physical form, I can't even hold them in my arms. And that's why we need to open a rupture on Earth to send our children through. We want them to live there as humans on a planet where I was born and where Eve and I first met. It was for the selfish reason that we interfered with normal space. However, once we send them through, we'll never intrude again. Hold on, do you really intend to send these newborns to Earth all on their own? How responsible can you be? We knew we would be incapable of reason. So we had already given up on having children. However, Leibniz convinced us to go through with it. I can't believe you're going to let mere dimensions get in the way of starting a family. And you already gave up your humanity. Seriously, just live your lives. If you can't take care of them, then let me handle it. That's why we're entrusting our precious children to Leibniz. He even brought the other MA pilots together to help slow you down. That's why he used Rising Garuda as the last line of defense, huh? Like I said last episode, these two don't know the truth. I see. This was all Leibniz's plan. No wonder he fought so hard. Even now, there are rampaging mutants out there who refuse Eve's will. The divergent life forms, known as lightning beings. A reference to blasting away. We have to do everything in our power to stop them. We can't watch over our children, but we can protect the world and the universe in which they live. We will protect it at all costs. The existence of those children is proof of your determination, huh? Allow me to say one more thing as a parent myself. They will be lonely, without a doubt. I understand that better than anyone. Even so, Eva taught me something. Eva did. Families' hearts are still connected, even when they're apart. And thus, they'll never be truly alone. She told me that even if you, her parents, weren't with her, she'd still be okay. However, if these children are ever in danger, we will go to them without fail. Please, forgive us for this. Dad. Regarding the interference nerves normal space carried out by Invem Queen and Blaster Master, it has been discovered that their intentions are to confront a new threat to the galactic peace and not to commit an act of aggression. To carry out the destruction order would mean losing a powerful ally. In combating this emerging threat, I have concluded they will not reverse the galactic peace that Sophia has been striving for. From here on out, we'll conduct no acts of aggression against you. The SF will never bother you again. I'll make sure of that. Kane, seriously, do you have any idea how hard it'll be to smooth things over with all SF's top brass? Listen here, Jason. What you've done is not wrong, but I'm still not going to commend you for it. You may not be wrong, still a huge responsibility. You say you'll still be connected, but it's not as simple as entrusting your children to someone else. I fought countless battles, not just to protect my family, but to ensure if I can be together with them. Never give up on the dream of living together with your family. You must bear that responsibility. Understood? Yes, sir. Eve, when Jennifer and I sent you off into space along with Sophia the Third, we never gave thought to the cruel fate you would come to face. For that, I'm sorry. even though you never wish to be in these circumstances, that you're still happy fighting for your dreams, it makes me so proud. Dad, thank you. After all this, we have your determination to thank for reversing our destiny and securing peace. And I have you to thank for the power to protect those important to me, as well as finally finding an irreplaceable family. I'm so glad I met you. Thank you, King Gardner. Alright, don't you two have a future to entrust in this universe to save? Godspeed, Blaster Master. And with that, that's the end of the Blaster Master Zero Trilogy. This is nostalgic. Honestly, I hope Integrate creates more Blaster Master games. Because honestly, these were good. Even though I'm not a big fan of 2, I still find the story good. I think the only thing I can think is just how emotional I am. You probably can't hear, but I am slightly tearing up. That ending always gets me. So, my thoughts on the project. Honestly, as just this project, it was fun. Honestly, I had a lot of good time. As a trilogy? Oh, as a trilogy, it was a blast. Being reminded of all this. Makes me happy that I did this. And this quick LP while doing Fire Emblem. Seeing leaving this ship makes me hope so much that they end up eventually doing a shmup with Leibniz, because Leibniz would fit. Especially her ship. Message being quite big. But that we have the ending cutscene, and then the one thing I want to show. That's what Path Leaving is. Head to our thread of fate. Hope you both grow up happy and healthy on Earth. Lena said, Libus will watch over them, and I'll make sure of that. He'll be okay. He said that if we never come back, he'll just tell them we're dead. I'm glad he's taking care of them, no, but still. Oh, he said the same thing to me. That definitely checks out. I'm not sure if that's the best thing for their well-being. Fred's got it right. As long as we're alive, we're still alive, it'll be fine. We'll do whatever it takes to return to Earth someday. Yeah, you're right. We'll return to Earth and live together as a family. I have so many things I want to tell them. Okay, I guess it's time. Let's go. Sophia J1. Launching.